What we're doing this morning is we're going to work through a thing called offensive principles of play. So these principles that we have, it'll be called motion with no screens. And we're going to do that for the first part of the clinic. And if we get time, we'll do a little bit of work on defensive footwork at the second or the last half hour of the clinic, depending on how much time we have. These principles of play, often when we start to teach offensive basketball, we're assuming with this group of guys that we have here, and I'm sure they'll be great demonstrators, but what underpins, what is essential for this type of play is good fundamentals. So here's what we expect players to be able to do from about the age of 14 onwards. We expect them to be able to pass and catch. It's really important to teach people how to catch the basketball in a number of different ways. Teach them in a stationary position, teach them how to catch on the run, teach them how to catch under pressure, particularly when they lead out. We expect them to be able to dribble with their head up and dribble with their right hand and left hand under pressure. This is from the age of even maybe 10 years on. We should be teaching our players these skills. We should also teach them how to lead for the ball and how to cut for the ball, how to cut away from the ball. We should teach them to shoot layups, both with their left hand and their right hand, so they can shoot those layups under pressure in the game. Remember, this is from the age of 10 onwards. So the most important thing is we must teach them to make a 6 meter jump shot, which is about here. They need to be able to make that shot 50% of the time. So when they do have to step back and make a three-pointer, it's no problem. So they're the expectations we have of the fundamentals required to play offensive basketball, regardless of which level, of which standard. So that underpins this motion with no screens that we're going to go through this morning. These are called principles of play, and when we've looked at offense, what's going to be important in offense, what will transfer to higher levels of play? If we're going to teach this to the junior players, will it give them the best skills then to be able to go and play at higher levels? Then when it's time to introduce screens, when it's time to introduce plays, will they be able to handle those? I think we need to teach this stuff first before we teach screening, because then it teaches them timing, it'll teach them spacing, it'll teach them how to lead, but above all, it'll give them confidence to be able to play so that they're able then to transfer and play at higher levels. So when the senior coaches get them, they're equipped with good skills to be able to play. Now, if I'm speaking quickly, let me know, because in Australia we speak quickly. So if you don't understand anything, please raise your hand. If you don't understand a term I use, basketball's full of different terms, please raise your hand. He was waving. I thought we had a question already. Okay. And if as we go through, you're not quite sure, then please ask a question as we go through, because then I can answer the question in the context here. That way it's much easier than try and hold questions till the end. I'd much rather you ask questions on the way through. If we approach the game logically, the first thing we try and do in basketball is to score. Everybody says, wow, that's a big interesting piece of news, but we try and score. And the first thing we do, we try and score, is we fast break. If we're playing a team that can move the ball up the floor quickly and score layups, then that's a pretty easy game, isn't it? If the team isn't good enough to get back, that's our first thing we look for in offense. What we do then is we start to build up depending on how good the defense is. So if the defense is good enough and takes away our fast break, what do we do next? What's our next principle of play we should look for so that we can start to exploit the defense? The next principle of play we have is ball reversal. I'll mention all these and then we're going to go back and work through them. That means we move the ball from one side of the floor to the other side of the floor and force the teams to close out and contain. That's one of the most difficult defensive skills to teach. So if we can expose that early, that will give us an advantage. But then the defense does a good job in closing down our ball reversal. So then we have to teach our players how to back cut, how to cut behind the pressure defense and still be able to maintain offensive spacing. So they're pretty good at defending our ball reversal. Now we have to penetrate off the dribble and get people into receiver spots. So when we draw the help, we can kick the ball for people to make good shots. And we've seen that through the camp today. Lots of the coaches here have been emphasizing to get to the corner when you're away from the ball. Get to the three-point line and have somebody back on defensive balance. So we'll go through that. So now the defense picks up another level and they're able to do that. What do we do then? Well, now we've got to work at playing off the post. How do we throw the ball into the post and what happens when that play happens? And of course, we have to teach the post some offensive moves, but what are our cutting rules? What are our positions once we throw the ball to the post? So now the defense denies the ball getting to the post. They're a pretty good defensive team so far, aren't they? They've stopped our fast break, stopped ball reversal, stopped our back cuts, and now they stop the ball getting into the post. So what do we do then? And the final piece of this is dribble entries. Instead of having to make a pass, we can't make a pass. We can dribble into the place we want the ball to go to, move a player out, move the post in different positions, and then play from there. Now, if they're pretty good at denying our dribble entries, then we have to screen, and that's a separate clinic. But you can see we'll have a lot of weapons, a lot of tools that we can use prior to get to screening that will help us play the game, that will teach our players, particularly when they're young, the offensive principles of play, so they can learn to play the game, they can learn spacing, they can learn timing, they can learn different positions, but also learn to play the principles of the game. Sometimes we move into screening too early and the players don't have an understanding of timing and space. So that's what we're going to aim to get through this morning, and I think we'll be able to get through this in the next hour that we've got left. We're planning to finish about 1 o'clock, I think, Florian, is it? Finish at 1 o'clock?
Yep.
So this first principle of play, fast break, okay, well, I think we can handle that. The next principle we have is ball reversal. Fellas, can we get three players up with a ball? Bring a ball with you. Just one ball. Let's have a player at the point, a player at the wing, and a player at the wing over there. Now, I'm going to teach this with three players. We'll have others come out as we go, but mostly three players. Three on three or three-man teaching is a very effective way of teaching concepts in basketball, because then we have mostly three-man plays or two-man plays in the game. We'll be talking on a combination of both in these particular plays, but I'll be using mostly three players. The point, the wing, and the wing. Where do we want our people to stand so we get good spacing? We'll change this as we go. If we're playing an offense, three out, two in, if I was to draw a line from the front of the basket through this hash mark to the three-point line, that's where we'd want our wing player to play. Because now, if we have a post, he can get a pass into the post, he can drive baseline or go into here. Our point man will play in line with the basket. So now he has two sides to play on the floor. And our other wing man will play a line from the front of the basket through this top hash mark to the three-point line. That's his spacing. So now we have room to move. So ball reversal, what does that mean? Let's put the ball here. There are three ways we can reverse the ball. One is through hand, so pass quickly from there, get it onto the next man, now bring it back. Bring it out, good. So that's the first method. The second method, hold it there. The second method is what we call a skip pass. If we want to move the ball from one side of the floor to the other, we have to make a good decision on where the help defense is. Pass the ball straight across. So we call that a skip pass because we skip out one of the players. So that's the third way, the second way. The third way is, if I'm in the post and the ball comes into me here, I can get it in the post and reverse it quickly to the player on the other side. So there's three ways of ball reversal. Why is it that ball reversal is so valuable for us? And here at the camp, we saw so many players being able to penetrate the ball off the dribble. Now, if I was playing man-to-man defense on, what's your first name?
Jeff.
If I'm playing man-to-man defense on Jeff, and the basketball is here, I'm playing on this line we call the split line or the help line. Because in good man-to-man principles, the further the ball is away from my man, the further I can be. So I'm on this split line, both hands up. If you make the pass across to Jeff quickly, this maneuver of me having to close out is very difficult. I have to stop Jeff from shooting the three-point shot. I have to stop him from penetrating and getting around me. That's the toughest defensive move to consistently teach. So when we're teaching offense, we need to test the defense and force them into situations where they can do this. So ball reversal is the first principle of play. We sweep down the floor, we set up, then we start to reverse the ball once, maybe twice, to get the defense to close out. And so we'll look at this now, what happens after we pass the ball. After you pass the ball, guys, we want you to make a V-cut. So Jeff, as you pass to?
Dominic.
Jeff, make your pass to Dominic. You'll now pretend that you're going to cut to the basket to get the ball back. So you'll make a speed cut straight at the rim, and once you get to the block, you'll lead back out. Meantime, Dominic, you'll get the ball onto Paul? Paul, is it? Bull. Okay, onto Bull. And now what you'll do, you'll cut to the foul line and come back and replace. So Jeff, you'll cut to the block and replace. You'll pass the ball out, Bull. Yeah, to Dominic. You'll cut to the block and come out and replace. Okay, good. Now just keep doing that quickly, okay? Move the ball, cut quickly, quick passes. Good. Hold it there. Now, what you have to do now is imagine you're gonna make a back cut and cut to the basket. Instead of just cutting in, just cut hard, give your baseline hand as a lead hand. So if you're gonna receive the ball back, don't pass it. What we have to teach the players to do is move with realism. Because if we make a pass here and we come in and stop and just come back out and jog back out, the defense knows what's going on. But if we teach the players to make a back cut first, now the defense can't read it well. And the instant the defense stands up and starts to look at the ball, we'll get a layup. So each time you cut and Bull, you cut, make it a hard cut, baseline hand, target hand. And the same with you here, Jeff.
Dominic, sorry.
You'll cut in hard and then you'll come back out. Okay, let's do that. Go. Cut hard, target hand, quick. Go, 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 cut hard, good. Good, catch the ball down, good stance. Good, cut hard, target hand, quick, move quickly. Target hand, good. Good, get it on, keep it going. Okay, now skip pass, to the wing, skip pass. Skip it across, still cut. Come back out, skip pass again. Good, good, cut, cut, cut. Each time you pass the ball, move. Good, now through hands to Dominic here again, good. Still thing, cut Dominic, good. Cut back, a good stance. Okay, hold it there, stop there, good work. So the principle of play we're teaching is each time you pass the ball, you must move. But we're trying to teach movement for a purpose. Not just meaningless move, meaningful move. So there's a purpose for the movement. This is going to be a back cut. We're trying to get the ball through hands. If there was a post player in here, we'd put a player. Let's have a post player up, fellas. Let's have one more player. Quick, anyone? In the post here, quickly. Just one. Okay, let's go through ball reversal. Now this time, what I'll call is skip or post. Or hands. If I call hands, you'll go through the hands. If it's a skip pass, we'll skip it. If it's a post, it'll go into you and you'll pass it straight across to Bull on the other side. Okay, hands. Still cut hard, good. Good. Post. Post. Good. Get it across quickly. Good. Now, as you make stop, as you make that pass now, you bust across to the other post. Yeah. Give a target hand with your baseline hand. Across you go now. Cut now. Go across the post now. That's it. Good. Hands. Hands. Skip. Skip. Post. Whoops. Catch it. Post. Post. Good. Bust across. Bust across. Good. Hands, hands, good, hands. Quickly, quickly. Good. Skip, skip. Post, post. Get it across, good, stop there. Good work, fellas. Good demonstrating, hold it there. Okay. So already we can see now, through ball movement and through meaningful player movement, that would be hard to defend without anything else. Because we can get the ball through hands, if that's denied, we can go through the post, we can get over. So straight away, ball reversal from one side of the floor to the other is a very important part of play, a very important principle of play. Okay, you can have a rest. Get a drink, fellas. Thanks. But it's important that players learn to move with a purpose, particularly away from the ball. And those speed cuts teach them that it's a back cut rather than a V cut, because then there's purpose in that. There's a little something in that for them to be able to get hold of. There might be a layup in it for them. If players know there's a score in it, I'm sure they'll do lots of good things to get the ball and score, because that's a good part of our game. Interestingly enough, we have to teach them, when we're leading, a couple of different techniques. If I want to lead to get the ball, it's good for the wing players to start here first on the block. Start in close, and then make a hard lead out for the ball, just a straight speed lead, we call it. And now, if they can't get it, outside foot's planted, left hand is up, and they just make a speed cut to the basket. Teach that basic move to the players first. Start in, but don't. If we start here, and now you start to lead out, now you're right away. You're way out here on the sideline, catch, and you're a long way from the basket. But if we start in, they have to be defended because they're close to the basket. So we're on the top of the block. So now they sprint out to get the ball. If now that's denied, now they can plant their outside foot, target with their inside hand, go to the basket, and maybe get a layup from that. So leading is a particularly important part of how to get the basketball. If the defense is good, if the defense is very good, fellas, let's get one of the guards coming out to defend me. Good, and another passer. Yep. What's your name?
Lungi.
Lungi. Lungi's going to defend me. You're going to be the passer in the forward spot. Yeah. Sorry, in the guard spot up there. Lungi's going to defend me. This will be an enormous task for Lungi. He has to be aware of my speed. Maybe. So I'm here. So if Lungi's up over here and I make this speed cut, just defend me right out. And so now he's still there. But he's good enough, because he's quicker than I am, snap your head and hand, to defend this back cut. So I'm in here, he's still defending me. What I have to do is drop low and get this inside foot over his lead foot. So I can swing this arm, outside foot's the pivot foot. So now I can swing it across here. So now he's behind me, and now I can lead out. Now, no matter how quick he is, I've still got him behind me, so now I can catch the ball. If he does arrive late and he's quick, he's so committed to the denial here, I can plant my outside foot and bang, I have a back cut through here to be able to make the layup. So the first leading technique is a straight speed cut in and out. The second technique is, if I've come here, Lungi's still there, I can drop low, outside foot, pivot foot, swing this foot across, so now he's behind me. If I'm close to the basket, I can simply post this way. If I want to come out because we have another action happening on the other side, I can now lead out. So those leading techniques are very important for our players. Otherwise, they can just race around and not be effective in getting the basketball where you want them to get it. So that's very important for us. Thanks, fellas. So once we've taught the players how to reverse the ball and look at the three methods of reversing the ball, through hands, the skip pass, and into the post and reverse it, now we can teach them how to cut effectively. And cutting is one of the very precise parts of the game that can be very rewarding when we're teaching motion, this type of motion with no screens. Let's get three guys up again, fellas, a point, wing, wing. So get some perimeter people up. Good work. A point. You play on the wing. So we've got point, wing, wing. Now, again, once we've reversed the ball, we have to see how purposefully we can cut. So now, fellas, let's reverse the ball. Did you see what the other players were doing beforehand? So you're going to make a speed cut. You're going to cut to the foul line back. You're going to cut, make a back cut and back. Let's do that first. Okay, cut, cut, cut quickly. Now hold it there, stop. See how the players now are cutting totally predictably. Where it pass and it's just run in, there's the line, I'll come back out. Cut as if you're going to make a basket now. So you'll be make a back cut. Don't be guided so much by the block. If you can, get to the basket and cut out. Make your cut as if you're going to get it and dunk and win the game. And you'll make a back cut here quickly as we go. Okay, good. Hard, hard. Good. Reverse it, good. Make your cut, go. Cut again, cut in and out again. Keep moving, in and out again. Good, in and out, good. Good, catch. Cut hard, good. Good, nice cut. Lead hand, give a target hand as if you want the ball. Good. Excellent, hold it there, fellas, good. Stop, good work. Stop there. Stop. Good. Now, so we've got our ball reversal happening. So now when we pass, we're now going to cut, make a cut. When you make the pass to the wing now, make your pass, we want you, the first move should be towards the ball. Good defenders are taught to do this. Ball back to here. You make the pass. The good defenders are taught when the pass is made, jump in the direction of the ball and force the defense behind us. Hold up. If a defender isn't quick, we need you to make your first move towards the ball, because if I don't jump to the ball, you can get a cut straight by my leg and now get the ball back for a layup. So as we make a pass for the top, and we have to teach this precisely. Sometimes players will pass and they'll move away. Pass, step to the ball, and now here's one of the most important principles, offensive principles in basketball that you'll hear. We now must look at the defender and see the position of the defense. The defense will teach us where to cut by their position. So the defense will instruct us where to cut by their position. So we've got to slow down a fraction to make the read and then explode into the moves. So I'm defending you here, ball here. So I'm down, I make that. If I don't, you see that, away you go and make your hard cut. Now, just cut through to the basket. Oh, okay. Go through now. Just cut through now. Good. Okay. Stop there, ball back. Ball back there, just hold there. Now, the people without the ball are the most important people in this offense. One of the big skills to teach is how do we move without the basketball? How do we move purposefully without the basketball? Now, if I'm defending, what's your name?
John.
John? Yep. I'm defending John, playing good man-to-man defense. So I'm off here. John has a look and sees this. What we need him to do is walk slowly in till he gets to the elbow, right here. And then he just pauses to see how I'm playing him, because he's now got two decisions. Once you get to there and see John moving in, you peel out, you cut out. Okay, so you cut out now. Do that now. Now, I'm playing John. Here's the deal. The passing lane is between John and the ball. If I'm up in this passing lane, by the time John gets to here, if I'm here, hold up, quite clearly that's a back cut for him, isn't it? Yeah. Because I'm here, make that cut. So bang, he goes and gets that. Ball back again. If now I'm playing back on this line here, John can come into the middle of the foul line, plant his foot, and then hit the top. Make the pass back. And now we're into reversal. And now you make your cut. Good. To the ball first. Now, hold it there. Ball back out. We won't make any passes in. Just come through to here, John. Now, you're now walking into here. And for this purpose, we'll plant a foot closer to the basket. Plant here and just get to the top of the key. Okay, do that. Now you're out. Reverse the ball. You cut. Good. Have a look and see. Plant. Good. Now you're out. Good. Still move. Still move. Good. Cut hard. Stop. Stop. Now, whoops. As soon as you make your pass, just cut quickly. Yeah. See, lots of players are taught when they pass to step away first. It's too slow. Step towards your pass first. Then you can see where the defense plays. Then you can make a speed cut and you're in much better shape to play. Okay, away we go. Pass, cut hard, good. Into the elbow. No passes in yet, just keep it going around the outside, yep. So we can demonstrate the principle. Away we go. Pass, good, into the, whoop, stop. See how you just drifted up? You could get 2 points here. Just walk into the elbow. Have a look and see, then explode up or make a back cut. See, if you just drift up, that's what a lot of junior players are taught to do all the time. And really, it's so predictable. Well, we're trying to teach players how to read the defense and react. So go into the elbow. Now hard to the top, good. You're out, good. Bang cut, speed cut, go, quick, quick. Cut through, good. Get it on, cut hard, speed cut, then up. Good. Hold it there, good, not too bad. Now, see, sometimes we need to be able to slow down and then accelerate so we can be more purposeful. If we just zoom the ball around quickly, reversal's good, but once we put cutting into it, if we're not careful, we can have the cutters going around and no one recognizes what's happening. So as the receiver gets the ball, you can make a one count. Catch the ball, face the basket, 1001. Now you can see, then get the ball on. Sometimes we go too quickly, we don't get a chance to explore what's happening. So we've taught cutting. Here's what else can happen now from this. Make your pass and cut. Now post up. Here's why this is so important for this player to come in and have a look. If we find, just stop there, if we find that the post player now is defended really well across the top here. You could hit the top of the key now, hit him with the pass, just step across me, seal, inside, make your pass, go to the basket, score. So we just had some 3-on-3 games. This would be a particularly good move for 3-on-3 where we make a pass, cut the post in, the defense denies the ball going inside. We have a player cut to the top of the key, it's high-low action, which is another principle of play that we use for all our offenses. No matter what sort of, whether it's man-to-man offense or zone defense or with screens, without screens, high-low action is a principle of play that's really important. So let's reverse the ball now. When the cutter cuts, get to the block, step to the elbow, come high, pass the ball high and into the post. Okay, go. To the top. Good. Good, get it out, do it, go again. Reverse it, then have a cutter into the block. This side, go this side, good. This side, into the block, step in, cut high. Whoops, no, we're gonna go high, low. Yeah. No, pass it to the man here, and he'll pass it in, good. Good, one more. Yep, whichever side. Good. Good. So we can see the person who's opposite the ball here, the player without the ball, is the most important part in this offense. The most important part, because they can get the high-low action going. So this principle of reading the defense, letting the defense instruct where we go by where they play, is going to be particularly important for us. Okay, take a seat, fellas. Any questions so far? So you can see as we're building it up, we've got ball reversal, we've now got some cutting action. If the defense is overplaying us, we can back cut. If they defend the post, we can go high, low. We've worked on the perimeter so far. The next principle of play we have is what happens if we get a good closeout and there's dribble penetration against the zone, or against man-to-man, I'm sorry. We have to get players into precise positions, depending on how the defense plays. We call them receivers spots or receivers positions. And these are based on how defenses would normally react or rotate. So if we talk about this from a three-on-three or a three-man perspective, then we'll demonstrate it four out, one in, which is the four people around the perimeter and one inside. And then we'll demonstrate it three out, two in. Three people outside and two people inside. Where do we want the receivers if we're able to get ball reversal and dribble penetration? Florian, grab me a water. Yep. Okay, let's get three guys up again, fellas. Three players. Point, wing, wing. Now, let's start the ball on the wing. Let's reverse the ball. Hold up. What do you do when you make that pass now? What do you do after you make the pass now? Yes, good. Get it on. Good. Let's go. Bring it back. Just get some movement happening. Good. Cut hard. Good. Okay, hold it there. Now, let's put the ball back. Let's say we get a dribble entry from the wing. We get dribble penetration from the wing. This defender's closed out, closed right out to the wing here, and you're able to dribble the ball inside. When we're teaching it in three on three, we need to have two positions occupied. Dribble in. Opposite the ball, you'll get to the, just hold your pass, you'll get to the deep corner. So we always have a player here because defenses normally will rotate across and then down. Help defenses will rotate across and then they'll rotate down. So we shift somebody into the deep corner, and then at the top here we need to have defensive balance. However, this player at the top can also read where your player is and step in just inside the three-point line, so you're in a position to be able to play. If this player goes across and this player comes down, you're shaping up here. So if the pass comes in, you can grab it and take that shot. Okay, bring it back out. Okay, so let's come back out. Make your pass. Good, come back out, reverse it. Dribble entry, get to the deep corner, deep corner. Either one, take the shot. All right, good, extra pass, good. Good, bring it back out, go again. So these are receiver spots. Thanks, mate. Good. Deep corner, away from the ball. Good. Take it. Go again, one more time, quickly. Keep going, fellas. Corner, corner. Nice job. Bring it back out. Let's get two more guys up, fellas. Two more players up. Let's go four out, one in. Four players out. You can go in. You're the biggest.
Yeah.
Now, we'll look at these two alignments, which are the two most common alignments when we're playing basketball. And firstly, what I want to do is talk about the precise positioning on the floor so we have enough room to move when we're playing. So when we look at four out, one in, these two guys, where the edge of the keyway hits the baseline, we draw a line up here and you'll stand right there. You'll be in the same position outside the three-point line where the foul line hits, you'll line up there. Guys on the wings, you'll line up on the wing, same position. So we draw a line from the front of the basket through this hash mark to here, so you'll be up here. You'll be in the same position on the other side. So now what we've done is we've got a lot of room to move along the baseline here. So our post player now can have two options to see where the ball is. And you can drive baseline or you can drive middle. You now, because of your precise positioning here, you can drive through the middle or you can drive through here. We'll have rules for the post depending on who drives the ball. And on this side of the floor, look at all the room you have to play in here now. You can drive to the baseline, you can drive through the top, and you can drive through the middle or you can drive through here. So when we're teaching players different alignments, it's critical that we're able to get them in precise positioning on the floor so they know exactly where they are, and it opens up opportunities where we can go two ways. If we had somebody too low here, and this is just to start with, because once the movement happens, it'll change a little bit. On the dribble penetration, we'll want somebody in the corner. Let's have a look and see what happens when the ball's on the wing here. What are our receiver's positions in four out, one in, as the ball is dribbled along the baseline? And this is on the post side. Now, let's say you're able to penetrate, just stay on the high side of the block. I should have mentioned this point. Great defense, great offensive position here. The baseline foot on the high side of the block is important. Because now, just come back out. If you're on your wing position, if you're able to pass the ball inside here, now our post player has two ways to go. If he gets forced down here too low and post down in a lower post position, when he catches the ball, if he was to spin, there's nowhere to move. He can only go one way, so the defense can trap that. But if he has one foot on the high side of the block, now he has two options to play. He can go high or he can go low, depending on which way he pivots. So that's really important for our post people. Baseline foot on the high side of the block, down, strong target. We call these two L's. This is one L and this is an L backwards. So they're in here, strong target, down low. So that's the position for our post player. Now, ball here. If you were able to dribble straight into the basket along the baseline side, no, don't set a screen. We've got no, all you do now is you loop out behind him. You'll step out here because here's what'll happen. Play on your post position. Normally, if he gets through, I will step out to help off the post. So you just pop straight back out and there's a shot there. So you will hook out behind, probably out to about here. So now you're in a position to shoot that. Hold up. Now on this dribble penetration, you'll go to the deep corner. Remember, you're opposite. So we want you down into the deep corner. Now with this play here, you'll get to this position right here. And now you'll be back on defensive balance. Just about there. So now we've had dribble penetration. You've looped out for a shot there. You've got your shot there. If the defense comes across here to help you, we've got a shot in the deep corner. Or we've got you right here. If your player has to go across and help out there, we've got you on defensive balance, but you can check and see where your players are. So let's go back again. Receiver spots, four out, one in. Dribble the ball along the baseline. Hook out. Down in the deep corner. Good. And give a target down there, as if you want to catch the ball and shoot it. Okay, let's go again. Hard, go hard this time. Hard, hard. Hook out. Good. Good. Bring it out again. This is with the on the post side. Okay, dribble hard. No, stop. Just same thing. All right, good enough. Good, we had ball reversal. Good work. Throw it out. Now, dribble baseline. Go hard. Hook out. Good. Good. Excellent. Back here on defensive balance. That's excellent. Bring it back out. Now, so our prime receiver spots, we have an area around here. Often we'll call this the dunker spot, where you can get into here, and I'm sure you can dunk. This is the dunker spot, the deep corner, safety, you'll hook out. So we've got those receiver spots as we're going. Ball back out here. Let's say now you dribble across the post, across the top of the post. You're dribbling inside this way. Hold up. Now, you will go to the basket on this. Step straight inside. You'll go to the deep corner. You'll flare. And you'll go back on defensive balance. Okay? So now we've got our receivers. You've come in over the top of the post. So if we help you get to the basket, the post will get underneath. We've got you in the deep corner. We've got you on the other side and you're back on defense, but you can read the defense as well. You can be an offensive threat as well. So now let's dribble across the top of the post. Go. Good. Because we're imagining the post player's man's come to help. So he needs to move. If he finds he can't get to the basket, you can just drop down to the inside, just below the block into there. Or you can go straight to the basket, whichever you want. Okay, bring it back out again. Dribble hard. Good. Good. Okay. Now, ball to you. Now, we have you coming in into the middle here again. So now the receiver spots are the same. You'll go to the basket. You'll get to the deep corner. You'll now float a little bit right down into the deep corner. You'll see what's happening there. You could even come into this spot here if you needed. But we'll keep you there. Now, instead of going to the deep corner, you have to make a decision, because if you've dribbled all the way in, hold up. If you go to that deep corner, who's back on defensive balance? No one. So what you would do is, you would have a look, but your first priority be back on defensive balance, because we've got a receiver here, we've got the deep corner, we've got another one across there. So you'd be back on defensive balance. Otherwise, if we took the shot and missed, all of our players are below the foul line. They'd get a fast break on us, okay? So dribble in, defensive balance, good. Receivers, good. Bring it back out. Good. Good, bring it back out. Good, now let's put the ball on the other side. Ball up to the other side. Now, same thing here again. Dribble in. Now, you will now, because you're opposite, you'll go to the deep corner. You'll go to the underneath the basket. You'll come into this spot here, and you'll be defensive balance this time because the ball's on your side. Okay, if you went down again, we'd have everybody down low, nobody would be back. So you would come out to here on defensive balance, but you'd also be looking to get into a position for a shot as well. So you're underneath, we've got the deep corner, we've got you into here, into this elbow, and now we're pretty good. Bring it back out, let's do that. Nelly. Okay, let's go. Receiver spots. Good. Okay, put the ball down into that corner. Okay, you dribble in along the baseline now. Ball there. Dribble in. Step right underneath. Step right into here. You're on the deep corner. You're back on defensive balance. Let's do that. Away we go. Inside, step in, good. Excellent, good. Now this time, look to the deep corner on this side, go. Hard, good. Take it. Not too bad, okay. Let's bring it out. Hold it there. So there are our receiver spots from four out, one in. So it's based on how the defense is going to classically rotate and go down to help, depending on dribble penetration. Once your players understand, we get the deep corners occupied, we get a safety, we get a man attacking the basket, another one at the dunker spot, then we're in pretty good shape to test defenses after ball reversal and dribble penetration. That's why ball reversal is such an important part of an offensive principle of play, because it forces teams to close out. It enables us to get dribble penetration, then we can get some receivers going in all spots, particularly under the basket. Question?
Thank you, Sam. My name is Coach Ngoni. Question is, is this best suited for when I have, for example, there are times when I don't have men big enough against my opponent and my team is smaller than my opponent. Is this what you'd recommend for my team against a bigger team, or is it best?
Yeah, I think it's best with any combination. If you've got a small team or a medium team, this creates space, it creates ball movement, it creates purposeful movement for the players. So it doesn't matter what your combinations are. You could have a small man inside and still play this, because someone close to the basket must be defended. So any combination's good. If you had a small team or a medium team, you could play this. But you can teach this to all players when they're 10, 11 or 12, because these are just principles of play. So whatever combination is fine. But it's a general, so it doesn't matter what size, then if the players all understand this, then you're in pretty good shape. Does that make sense? Now, fellas, let's put someone else in on the post. Yep. Now, you're at the point. Now, the other popular alignment in our receivers principles is three out, two in. And this is played against man-to-man. It also is played against zone. But we're principally talking about man-to-man defense here. So what are our receivers principles now? They're exactly the same. We have a post player, except we've got two people in. Now, you dribble baseline, you will hook out again. Sorry, you'll dribble in along the baseline. You'll hook out again. Now this time, you will step. You can either do two things. You can lift, just lift to here. You can go to the deep corner and you're on defensive balance. Or depending on where his player is, as he lifts, you can move into here. So you can lift first, so we create some space to get that pass across, or you can move into here. But if the defense didn't play really well, you could often step down low to the basket as well. But for the moment, just lift and then step into here. You're on defensive balance, but still looking for a shot. You're in the deep corner. Okay, so bring it out to the wing again. Again, the post player will drift out. But again, in a principle of play, if we saw your player go so close to the ball that you could step straight into the dunker spot, you could do that as well. But for the moment, let's just get you to hook out of there as the dribbler goes by. Okay, baseline side. Dribble in, go hard, hook out, deep corner. Good. Good. Go again. This time hit the man in the deep corner. Go. Just hit the ring. Here we go. Good. Excellent recovery. Good shot. Well done. Now, let's dribble in from the top here. Let's say you get by here and dribble into the middle. Okay, into that way. Now this time, you can go to the basket. You can either go to the basket or lift. Deep corner. The man opposite the ball will always go to the deep corner and you'll go back on defensive balance here, but you'll still be in position for a shot too in case your man gets caught watching. So let's come back again. So we dribble in through the top. Good. Nelly, bring it back out again, dribbling through the top. Receiver spots. Good. Nice job. Okay, ball on the other side, it's the same thing now. If we've got a post that's high or low, say you're in the high post, just come up a bit higher, and you're in the low post. Now, you dribble along the baseline. What you can do now is simply, hook out, but into here now. You go to the basket. You're opposite, so get to the deep corner, and you're back on defensive balance. The man who's opposite the ball will always get to the deep corner. So now, because his defender is going to have to rotate down. If I came across to the ball here, and his defender was coming down, would be there, or you're there. So now it's important that we're able to get that happening. Okay, bring it back out. Let's go. Good. Pretty good. Okay, now, you're in the low post. You're in the low post, ball there. Dribble baseline side. Hook out. Good. You'll step underneath. Step in underneath. Right into the dunker spot. Good. Now you've got here, here, or here. Whoever you want. Okay, bring it out, go again, quick. Dribble in, hook out, good. Now this time, let's dribble over the top. Stay in the low post, ball to the wing. Dribble over the top, in through the top. Now, again, you can just step out or into the basket there. You can go right there, just hold right there. You're in the deep corner and you're back on defensive balance. So let's do that. Good. Okay. Take a seat, fellas. Take a seat. Well done. So far we've covered this. We've covered ball reversal. If the defense is defending us, how to back cut. We've covered how to lead for the ball. We've also covered after dribble penetration, where do we get our receivers? From an alignment of four out, one in, and an alignment of three out, two in. So now we're starting, we've covered purposeful movement without the basketball. And that's what receiver spots are. All the receivers are without the ball. So we have to get them in position for a prime purpose. And then we can start to test and see how the defense plays us. So that's a pretty important part of our offensive principles of play so far. Now, as we discussed at the beginning, as the level of the defense picks up, we have to add some more things to our game. So if they're able to deny us our ball reversal, they're pretty good at penetrating off the dribble. What do we do now to help us attack the basket but involve our big guys a bit more? Because we've had a lot of perimeter play, so now what offense are we going to run to help our big guys get to the basket and be stronger? Fellas, let's get six players up, three in dark tops and three in light tops. Six guys up, three lights, three darks. Quick swap. So put reverse your tops. Who are the three light guys? Who are the three that are in white? Okay, let's get a point, a wing, and a post player. Quick. White ball. So you get a post player here, get a wing over here. A wing on this side. Who's in the post? Someone in the post, guys. Match up, fellas. Looks like you're in the post. Who are you defending? I think you should defend the post. You're here. So here we're playing four out, one in. Let's say, and what we're going to do now is, this is called a breakdown drill. In basketball, where we have three-man plays or two-man plays, we'll break the skill down so we can teach it and then put it back. So we'll show them the whole bit, but then we'll break it down, then we'll put it back together again. So this is a breakdown drill, three on three, to reinforce our post principles. So, our post player's got his baseline foot on the high side of the block, slide up a bit further, right there. We've got the ball, you'll come out a little bit. Okay, just hold up, just stay there. We've got our wing player in a good position, just come up a bit higher. Front of the basket, the first hash mark here, so we've got plenty of room here to move. You're in line with this line here, about a metre outside, so you're here. So our spacing's not bad. This enables us, our offensive guys, to read and see how the defense are playing us. By the virtue of the fact we've got them in good position, we can now start to pay attention to where the defense is playing, and now we can help. It helps with our decision making, because the defense will instruct us depending on how they play. So now we've got this. Put the ball here at the wing. We can't get the ball into the post yet, and also we're finding now that this pass is being denied. So, what we need our post player to do, you now have to recognize this. When we're talking about reading the defense, Well, not only talking about the defense on us, on our individual player, but we're also talking about how the defense plays away from us, because that will also determine where we pass the ball. So you have to read this and see this. That pass is being denied. We can't get it in. So now, if you simply step out into the, we call this the short corner area, make the pass to him, hold it there. Now, you now back cut. Cut, hold up. You cut behind him to the basket and now throw it in for a layup. Except we'll only play on this side of the basket, because in a real game, where would the help defense be? On that side of the basket. Okay, so throw the ball out. Okay, throw the ball out. Now, let's stop and have a look. So we see this. We see this is denied. We can't get the pass in. We can't get it into you. Okay, so now put the ball down here again. Okay, now this pass can't be made. This is denied. Here's the deal. The ball goes into the low post. Hold up. We teach this what we call prescriptively first, in a set order first, and then we can change it as the players understand. The worst thing that can happen when the ball goes into the post is people stand still. The ball goes into the post right here. You cut hard. Hold up. Good. Now you'll chase him, of course. But you're on this side of the basket. Stop there. Now you relocate. If your player has looked at the ball now, you'll relocate up to the into the corner here. Yep, so we can get a shot there, or we might get a shot there. So let's bring it back. So we have a cutter and a relocator. So in every post play, after a pass is made to the post, there's a cutter and a relocator. We don't have people stand, otherwise that's where we get double teamed on the post. Okay, let's do that. Start the ball here. Good, pop out. Good, cut hard, relocate. Now we won't make that pass, will we? Because that's where the defense is. You have to place restrictions on players. We're only going to play on this side of the court because it's not realistic. In a real game, there'd be players on the other side. We can score here because there's no help defense, because there's only 3-on-3. Okay, bring it out. Wing. Pop out. Good, cut. Relocate. Good. Okay, now good, play. Play, good. Receivers, not too bad. Okay, bring it out again. Now, the ball's with the player at the top. Move out a bit. So now, I'll be you for a second. Not quite as big. So the ball's at the top here. There's some important footwork here that we need to look at for the post. I'm down here, we want to make sure we're going to try and get the pass here, but that pass can't be made. This is an important offensive principle here. Three important principles for our post player. I want to try and lead up now and get that ball. Well, the first thing I do is give a catch fake. I'm down, but I give this catch fake behind his head. So what instinctively he'll do is turn. Now, again, outside foot, pivot foot. I stay low. I've given the catch fake, one hand or two. I swing underneath, bringing this foot through in over the top of his. Now he's behind me. Then I take a big stride step and jump stop right on the elbow here with this foot where the circle hits the free throw line. You pass the ball to me. You'll come to me. Now you're going to back cut, but I'm going to reverse pivot with my foot closest to the split line, middle of the court is my pivot foot. I'll show you why in a second. So now I follow the cut around. You go, I might be able to get that pass through. Hold up. But if I can't get the pass through, so I've caught the ball here, you cut. This movement, I rip it across here. He's got to come across and defend this right across. Now I'm set up for a crossover, one, two, power dribbles and a power move to the basket. That's why it's important to have your middle, your foot closest to the midline, or the split line is your pivot foot. So now when I fake that pass, if he doesn't come, I can go there. If he comes across, I rip the ball across and go straight down the lane for a power move. So, catch fake. Step across and stay low. come to a jump stop, inside foot, foot closest to the middle of the floor is your pivot foot, reverse pivot. They're the five principles for the guy in the middle. Get all that? Good. Let's see. So, the pass is here. This is being denied. So now this is when the pass from the wing to the top is being denied. Remember, they're trying to stop us from ball reversal. Okay, give it, stop, sorry. The ball's here. Sorry, we'll do that again. It's when the pass is being denied from the point to the wing. Sorry, we covered the other one first. I just got mixed. So we see that. Give the catch fake behind his head. Good. Ball in. Good. Good. Go again. Not too bad. Quick, bring it out. Good. Not too bad. Good. Now, what do you do? We've had a... What's he? He's the relocator. So let's do it again. You hold the ball this time. Give the catch fake. Step under him. Come through. Good. Okay. Go. Hold your pass. Now, you'll recover to him. Now, you will, yes, relocate to here. So now hit him. Pass to him. You've either got a shot or you can dribble penetrate. So again, principles of play. Every time the ball goes to the post, we have a cutter and a relocator. So we have two options each time the ball goes inside. Okay, let's go through it again, fellas. Good, let's hit the relocator this time. Good. Good. Whoop, I don't think that'd be there. That's a shot for you there. Remember that we're going to have another four people playing there. Okay. One more time. Quick. Quick, quick. Here we go, fellas. Catch fake. Catch fake. Step through. Hit him. Good. Good. Nice job. Okay. Let's take a rest, guys. Have a seat. Good work. So... they're our principles of play with for our post guys. And it's important that we involve them in the game because they can relieve a lot of perimeter pressure on the outside. So it's particularly important that we're able to teach them how to recognise where the defence is playing on them, but also how the defence is playing on our perimeter players, because that'll determine where they move. Now, I said before, we teach that prescriptively at the moment. In other words, we teach it in strict sequence. But what eventually will happen is, you might change the cutting rules depending on how the defense plays the post. For example, the person on the perimeter here may want to go down and double the post. So now this player will cut differently to the way we just taught it there, depending on what your scouting report will tell you regarding how teams are going to play defense on the post. So now, what we've seen is, ball reversal, that's been taken away. Back cuts because they've been denying the perimeter. We've had dribble penetration with receivers because again our perimeter stuff's been denied. And we've also seen now what happens when we throw the ball into the post. So now the defense denies the ball to the post. So what's the next phase that we do? What's the next thing that we teach? And as I say, they're a pretty good defensive team. They're a pretty good defensive team. And now they've taken away our fast break. They've taken away ball reversal. They've taken away dribble penetration. They've taken away our pass to the post. So now the next thing that we do is we dribble against the defense. Fellas, let's get three more guys up. Quick. Oh, sorry, we'll just need two. We'll just need two. So you're on the wing, you're at the top here. Get a couple of shots. Now, the first thing we've spoken about, we're playing either, well, let's say we're playing three out two inch. You're up here on the wing spot. The first thing we do, we teach on any dribble entry, and it goes back to the thing we demonstrated first. If I'm down, if the defense is down here denying this, here's the cue for you. You're keeping good eye contact. You're keeping good eye contact across here. You will dribble at him. As soon as the ball hits the floor, you're going to make a speed cut to the basket, a back cut. Make a pass, hit him, and lay it up. Good. So that's the first dribble entry series we have. So remember, the defense is tough. We're being denied. We can't get it across here. And straight away, we have a rule here. Never fake a backdoor cut. How many times do you see this happen in a game where we go here, we come out, we go, he goes, and the ball goes flying out over the sideline? Instantly there's eye contact here, you will make a speed cut straight to the basket and keep going. Even if you think the defense has got you covered. You see, with your athleticism, what we could do is just throw it up to the ring and you would still beat him and grab it and throw it down. Never fake a backdoor cut. So the instant the first pass is made, you sprint to the basket, catch it and go. Okay, here we go. Dribble, cut, throw it. Good. What it does also, it creates a much better angle for the pass to be made, either through the chest pass or the lob. We only want him to have to put the ball on the floor once. So if he has to put it on the floor twice, cut, now that's a much tougher pass on that angle than this angle to get to the receiver, to get to the cutter. So it's one bounce, he's sprinting to the basket. What effect will that have on the defense if he scores first, first time he gets it? The defense won't be up here defending with as much pressure as before. So now they'll be off a little bit. Now we can get the pass. Because the reason we have dribble entries in this is because the defense is playing so tough, we can't make a pass. So effectively, we're dribbling in, which we'll cover next, to where the receiver is. But on this case, it's a back cut. Let's do one more. Dribble hard at him. Cut, go. Good. Good job. Okay, bring it back out. Okay, one more. Good. Nice job. Okay, bring it back out. Now, what's the next dribble entry series we have? We call it dribble entry and a post-up cut. So what you'll do this time, you'll cut hard to the basket, get your head right underneath the basket, head right under the basket, no, head right under the basket, right there. Now this is an important teaching point. Now you'll dribble around into his spot. So we can't pass here, so now we dribble around here. Why is it important for our offensive player to get his head under the basket? Well, it forces the defense to play one of two ways. It forces the defense to play on this side or this side. So once you see which way I'm playing, like if I'm playing here, it's quite simple. Get down low, baseline foot pivot, swing this foot across and post me up. Throw it in, up you go. Good, and he can go up either side, ball out. If I'm playing on this side of him and his head's right under the basket, now he just simply backs me down and now he can get a good shot underneath. But if he only cuts to here, I can just play here, not play him at all. But he's right under the basket. Someone has to defend that. So if it's a help defender coming down, we'll have people open on the perimeter. If it's me coming right in under here, now he can see which way I'm defending and he can go either way. So let's come back out to the top. So this is dribble entry and a post-up cut. Okay, away we go. Hard, dribble hard at him, cut hard. Good. Now don't bounce it there. So there'll be some help defense down there. You put it on the floor, they'll get it. Okay, bring it back out. Go hard, right underneath, good. Good. Now, as you come in, there's still an option here for you as well. You keep your dribble alive. Get to here, because now if he posts, you might have a move here where you could make it and take it down to here, where you could pop high, you can get a shot, or we can get it to him in there. So keep your dribble alive, keep bouncing it until you make a decision whether to pass to him or whether you've got an option yourself. Come back out.
My brother.
Wake up. Good. Nice job. Let's put another player out, guys, on the wing here. Put another player up. Quick. Quick, quick, quick. Yep, good work. Now, this all relates, goes back to our first three-on-three play. Let's say we run a dribble entry cut from here. Way you go, dribble. Make your cut hard, post up. Now, let's say the defender defends that. You could come into here. Now cut high, hit him. Now we go high-low, pass down to him. So our dribble entry cut fits with our first sequence of three on three. If we had a third player in, we can see how this starts to fit together. So we combine the dribble entry, the post up cut, now with some action on the help side where we can go high low. Let's go one more. Good. Throw it in. Good. Good. One more. Good. Good. Nice job. Bring it back out. Now, this next skill is quite a simple skill. It's a dribble handoff. But again, we've got some precise teaching points on how we execute this dribble handoff. So, again, we've had our back cut. We've had our post-up cut. Now we dribble hard at the wing player here, but we're aiming to get to this elbow here. So you'll do one or two bounces and come to a jump stop. Now, the position for the handoff, you're going to come around for this handoff. The position on this is critical for us. We want the hand position to be north, south, or top, bottom, where we're down here. So we're down here, top, bottom, you will come off, hold it there. Now we have a look and see. If he can wipe his man off here, you can turn the corner and drive. If he turns the corner and drives because he's got the good drive to the basket, I just simply pop out. I pop out to here, okay? If this happens, I've come to the jump stop, I've got the top hand, bottom hand. If this happens where the defense forces him out a bit wide, I can roll, crab down the lane, get the ball and take a shot from there. Okay? So let's go again. Did you get that? Come to a jump stop. One hand on the top. Why we have this hand position here on this is because now there's no fumbling. There's no two hands here and his hand hits mine. It's a clean take and now he's in good shape to move. What we'll do now is drive to the basket and he'll pop out. Okay? Let's go. Good drive. Good. Nice job. Bring it back out. Dribble handoff. Come to a jump stop. Good. Good. Let's go again. This time mix it up however you want. Good. Nice job. Now this time, dribble handoff, but instead of going all the way, dribble back out and you go and post up. Yeah, you'll hand off, you'll catch the ball, dribble out to the top, you'll roll and post up. Okay, let's go. Good. Hit him. Good. Good, let's bring it out again. Good. So now we can start to combine things as well. Now our receiver, you can get down into the deep corner. Okay, let's go again. So we've got a dribble handoff on this side. What's happening to our player on the far side? Okay, away we go. Dribble entry. Come off. Down to the deep corner. Good. Not bad, good. Okay, bring it out one more time. This time, post-up cut. This time it'll be, as you dribble hard at him, come as if you're going to take the hand off, but then you'll cut to the basket and post up. Okay? Go. There. Go. No, no. Keep your dribble alive. Yeah, you're right. Dribble alive and then go out. Okay? Good. Post up cut. Keep it alive. Good. Let me demonstrate it with you. Okay? So I'm coming here. I'll go post up, post up. So I go wide out to right underneath. Whoops. Right underneath. No, head under the basket. Head under the basket. Good. Now we can play from there. Okay, not bad. Okay, got it? Let's do that. Good. Okay, not bad. Bring it back out. Okay, what's the last series in our dribble entry series is a shallow cut. So now what we're going to do is dribble at you. You will simply cut through the middle of the key and then up to the corner here. Sorry, up to the top here. So you'll keep your dribble alive. Dribble alive. Shallow cut. Up to the top. Right out. And now we can play. Let's put you in the post now. Let's bring it out. Bring it back out again. No, in the post on this side. You're on the wing. You're on the post on this side. So we can have a shallow cut on the post side or the side away from the post. Now, if we've got a strong post player here, and we want to try and get the ball into him, but this is being denied, and the post player is so physical that he can't really make a cut to the top here, we can dribble at you. You'll shallow cut around the baseline side of the post player and then cut high. Okay, let's do that. Dribble at him, shallow cut around, hold up. Now, we couldn't get the pass here, but we've been able to dribble here. Now we're in good shape to throw it into the post. Hold up. You cut first. No, no, no. Cut straight down here, because your man will be here. You cut straight down there. Relocate. Now we've combined two principles of play. So now we're teaching the players how to think and react and see how the defense is playing us. In this case, we want to get the ball to the post player, but we can't get the ball in here, so we have to dribble entry. So now he becomes the passer, but then we hit the post, so we're into our cutting rules. Player first will make the cut from the top, he'll go to the basket. This player will relocate, come around to here, and now we're in good shape. Okay, let's do that again, fellas. Shallow cut around the post, away we go. Good. Hit the post, all good. Hit the post, cut, relocate. Now, if you don't get either of those, just spin to the baseline, make it. No, no, other foot, your pivot foot. No, no, just drop step. There, power it. Do this. One bounce.
Okay.
That sounds pretty good. Okay, let's do it again. Shallow cut. Hit the post, first cutter, second cutter, boom, not too bad. Let's go again. Shallow cut, hit the post, first cutter. Okay, not bad, not bad. Okay, this time hit the relocator. Okay, shallow cut. Good, hit the post. First cutter, relocate it, take your shot. Good. Not too bad. Good, bring it back out. Okay, let's get two other guys up quickly. Two other fellas, quick. Two players, quick. Quickly. Question, yep.
On the high post, okay. We were saying the guy to the wing that side should hit the down post. But I can see that the ball is facing this side. And that player was supposed to be our defensive player.
Safety?
Safety play. But we are taking him down, so we will be having a wing and a post. So we will be the one picking someone.
It's a good point. In 3-on-3, when we're drilling in a breakdown, we'll drill without the safety guy. But if we go back to 4-on-4, we would have the safety man back. Okay, so in 3-on-3, it's a very good point, good question. It looks as if we're not being responsible for our safety, but it's a breakdown drill in 3-on-3 on this side of the floor. But on the side away from the ball, we would have somebody back here on defensive balance. Does that make sense? Yeah, good question though. Okay, now, let's just play offense, guys. 4 out, 1 in. 4 out, 1 in. Good. Hold up. So now we've got motion with no screens. We add it all together. That's the final play, the dribble entry series. So now we've got our fast break happening. The defense shuts down the fast break. So now we've got ball reversal and receivers. Let's just do that. Let's reverse the ball 3 times. And when I call receivers, then dribble in. Any one of you 4 guys on the perimeter can dribble in. You're on offense. Everybody's on offense now, okay? Ball reversal, quick, through hands, go. Quick, 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 move, 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 stop. Where to play a pass and you stood. Yeah, you gotta pretend, make a back cut here, come back out. Each time you pass the ball, you must move. Even if it's a replacement cut, okay, go. Move the ball, quick. Good, move, move. Penetrate, dribble entry, dribble, dribble, dribble in. Receivers, receivers. Not too bad, hold up. Deep corner here, you could have been here, you should have been up here. Defensive balance, you're a receiver, you're a receiver. You'll go straight to the basket as he penetrates from that side, receivers. Okay, let's put the ball on the wing here. Okay. Okay, you can cut through now, pass and cut, cut through. There's a good penetration, come back out. Hold the ball up, we'll just send a cutter through. Okay, away we go. Cut, cut. No, all the way through, all the way through. Bring it out, it's not a bad option. If he's not sure, he just drives. Bring it back out. This time, pass and cut. So pass to the wing, yep. Come up. Cut, cut through, cut through, cut through. Balance, come in and balance. Hit the post, hit the post. Now you should be out now. Remember, you're cutting out. We've only got 1 guy in. Okay, ball starts here. Ball starts here. You're in the post. Come up. Now, cut high, low to high, hit the post. No, no, pass to the post. Here we go. Pass to the post. No, no, you're just right here. Elbow. Now, you're going to reverse pivot. Cut. Cut through. You're relocating. Good. Now, on that, hold up. You 2 guys on this side now, your defensive balance. This goes back to your question, coach. Coach, this goes back to your question here. We're now your defensive balance. You're now in the deep corner. So now when we add this together, we can see that we've now got post action, corner action, 2 cutters, defensive balance, and somebody in the deep corner. Okay, let's go again. Okay, hit the post, pass to the post. Cut, no, no, stop. See, if he gets it, you cut first and you relocate, just hold the ball. Let's do it again. Okay, throw it in, cut, relocate. Good, deep corner, you right for a shot there? All right, well look, thanks very much for your attendance. It's been a pleasure here to have the clinic for the Basketball Without Borders coaching clinic here. You've been great attendance, some great questions, and I hope you're able to take this back and teach it to the young players and reinforce these principles of play. Thank you, all the best.